so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Those stained of that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free.
It is a great pleasure that I welcome you to the Mission San Jose High School commencement exercises for the graduating class of 1990. 1 year ago today, I told this same audience that I had just completed my freshman year at Mission San Jose High School. And here I am today, also graduating with a class of 90. The events that are occurring in the world around you, and strive to enhance those ideals in your own lives. This class can do it. We're a culturally diverse nation. Be open to people of all backgrounds and do your part to promote racial harmony in our world. You've done it at Mission, you can do it. And lastly, your positive contributions have made a difference in my life and the lives of all the staff members at Mission High. An exceptional group of people. And you have the power to make a difference in everything you do from now on. Do the right thing. You can do it. In conclusion, I would like to say that if tomorrow's leaders are coming from this group of people, then we can all rest easy knowing that our future is in good hands. Thank you.
Class of
1990. And thank you to everyone at Mission High for these special years. There will always be a little warrior green and white next to my heart. Thank you very much.
We're sitting here today and we're surrounded by teachers, friends, and relatives who have supported us through the years. I have so many feelings right now that cannot be put into words. I'd like to share with you the lyrics of a song written by Dionne Warwick. Don't worry, I'm not going to sing. The song is called There's a Long Road Ahead of Us. I want you guys to pay attention. It's a special song. You've been thinking that the good old days are far behind you, but there's a beautiful side of life that you've been blind to. And in case you didn't know, let me remind you, there's a long road ahead of us. And the world is ours. You only trust in you and me. Love never stays the same. Don't let it get you down. Old dreams can fade away, but new ones can be found. You're just too young to be living on a memory. Where I'm coming from, the best is yet to come. Because there's a long road ahead of us, such a long road ahead of us, and the world is ours. You just trust in you and me. I'm not saying there won't be a stormy time to weather, but we can rise above it all together. Because today is just the first day of forever, and the world is ours.
Too, but I'll just kind of muddle through this. I look back 4 years ago and I see how different everything was. At the beginning, we saw life through innocent, immature eyes. Now, it's 4 years later and the end of our high school career. We're about to enter another phase of life. For some people, college, and others, the workforce. And some just might take off a few years to figure out everything. But high school has been 4 years of rewards and mistakes. After each mistake, you picked yourself up and went on with even more knowledge than before. If we were perfect, we wouldn't do anything wrong, but we're human, and we learn by trial and error. That's the only way knowledge can stick in our brains. We've grown so much and have experienced so many things, good and bad. It's time to leave, and a time to learn. We'll always be learning, and we'll always be together in our hearts. Good luck, class of 1990.
Good morning. My name is Lori Fink, and on behalf of the graduating class of 1990, I would like to thank you all for sharing in this momentous occasion. Each and every one of you have contributed to this graduation in some way. Whether you be our families or friends or teachers, you've all helped us be here today. So to our friends, we thank you for always understanding us and giving us someone to lean on until we can stand alone. To our teachers, we thank you for tolerating us for 12 years, but mostly for sharing your knowledge and devoting your lives to our future. And finally, most importantly, to our parents, who've always been right behind us, whether it be to push us just when we thought we couldn't go any further, or to catch us when we were falling. Today we say goodbye, but tomorrow we begin the rest of our lives, searching for our place in the world. And each one of us will find a place. To the class of 1990, here are my hopes for you.